Dear students, welcome to online classes, Bangalore University, Digital Learning. Dear students, today I am talking about the novel Animal Farm. This novel is prescribed for Bangalore University students, third semester BA, Additional English. Earlier session, I talked about chapter 8 and how the chaos was happened in the Animal Farm. Again, Napoleon's cruelty, which was revealed so beautifully in terms of, his leadership was not a successful one. And he sold, timber to Mr. Frederick. That was again proven his, misleading leadership, the kind of a conspiracy he was having. And Frederick, Mr. Frederick, befooled Napoleon and his company, especially the animal farms. Due to that, the battle had happened. In that battle, the animals finally succeeded to pull out of the, pull out the human beings from the animal farm. There you could notice, the gesture of Napoleon as well as Squealer. See, Napoleon once again take the name of Snowball in order to misuse his representation, whereas he is nowhere on screen. Now we will have a complete discussion about the important themes as well as analysis of this particular chapter 8 on Animal Farm. Okay, dear students, now we will have a we'll have a look at the themes. The themes, obviously, the propaganda which works throughout the animal farm, when the animals become upset because they are always hungry, as we have known that the animals are turning out to be an impatient fellows. They are feeling hungry rather than the earlier times. Why means they have started to reconstruct the windmill. That is the reason why they are working very harder in field as well as busy with rebuilding the windmill. Squealer starts reading to them every Sunday from long strips of paper, telling them that the production of every type of food on the farm has increased 2 or 3 or even 500%. It was completely wrong. What he read in this paper, especially in every Sundays, it was a complete misconception and misled. He misled the animals with giving such kind of a false statistics. The animals do not remember very well what conditions were like under Mr. Jones earlier, the farm owner, and so they do not dispute this. See, Napoleon leans towards selling the timber. Now, this is the very important setback which has happened in the chapter 8. He wanted to sell his timber which are there in animal farm to either Frederick or Pilkington. Soon he knew that Frederick is planning to take over animal farm, and with a group of armed men. And has already bribed the magistrates and police to let it happen. See, look at that. Once Frederick took the timbers from Napoleon, and he had a beautiful plan. Make sure that he coalesced with the police as well as the other magistrates. He bribed them and had a beautiful plan to attack against animals in animal farm, and that Frederick tortures and starves his animals. Napoleon tells the pigeons that he sends out to neighboring farms to drop their slogan of death to humanity. Look at that. Death to humanity means it is our duty to kill human beings, and replace it with death to Frederick. Now that the animals have finally accepted the Squealer's version of the Battle of the Cowshed, Squealer's version of the Battle of Cowshed is nothing but he once again changed the complete concept by taking Snowball as a villain of that Battle of Cowshed. And remember this as the true version. He is able to convince them further that they are still remembering things wrong, and Snowball was in fact criticized for his cowardice in the battle. When Napoleon changes his mind and sells the timber to Frederick, see, this is what the change you have to look at in this particular chapter. Changing of commandments every now and then, as far as the convenience of the pigs, and Napoleon, he himself changed the plan, selling the timber to Mr. Pilkington rather than Frederick. See, look at that. He changed his plan again. He sold timber to Frederick. Then all these stories are immediately changed so that the animals will not think that Napoleon has acted inconsistently. He tells them that the rumors of an attack are totally untrue, that he has been in agreement with Frederick secretly the whole time. Look at that. Earlier, he came to know the plan of Mr. Frederick, and immediately he changed his scenario. There he took use of the pigeons to spread the message to kill the human instead of to kill the Frederick. This is what you have to notice. How frequently Napoleon changes according to the circumstance, and that the rumors of cruelty to animals and pinch feed probably originated with Snowball. Again, he took the name of the Snowball instead of talking about Frederick, who is not a pinch feed after all, but has been living in luxury at Foxwood for years. Look at that. Snowball is living a comfortable life, a dignified life, and a very wealthy life at the luxury of Foxwood for years. So he says he only pretended to be friendly with Pilkington and to get Frederick to raise his price. That is the kind of a propaganda Napoleon used that was not worked so properly. Instead of selling timber woods to Mr. Pilkington, he sold to Frederick, and immediately Frederick attacked on the animal farm. After Napoleon has several of the animals executed, the sixth commandment has mysteriously changed and now reads. Look at the changes of commandments for every sequent situations. No animal shall kill any other animal without cause. The term comrade originally meant to remind everyone that all the animals are equal becomes completely meaningless when used in connection with the general hero worship of Napoleon. See, look at that. The term comrade, which lost its meaning, it is not supposed to be stand for all animals are equal. It almost finally came out of the kind of a concept. Napoleon is turning out to be a hero, and he is turning out to be a unmatched hero and undisputed hero, though he is having lot of drawbacks with his leaderships. The greed is there, obviously. Napoleon is still hungry for more power and more status. That is the reason why he took all the credits of building the windmill, as well as selling the timber to Frederick, and plotting that kind of a battle. Finally, he was responsible of killing a lot of animals inside the animal farm, which was not at all there in earlier times. He issues all his orders through Squealer or one of the other pigs, and avoids going out in public more often than once every 2 weeks. Look at that. Earlier, at least he used to come come and address the public once in every week, but this time he appeared in publicly once in every 2 weeks. Look at the change of Napoleon. When he does appear, he is attended by his dogs. Look at that. There is a scarcity, there is a kind of a inappropriate appearance to the Napoleon is there. That is the reason why he took the support of the dogs. Whenever Napoleon appears on stage, means he appears with the dogs and the support of the black corporal. In the farmhouse, he moves into separate apartments from the others, takes his meals alone with two dogs waiting on him. Look at that. Look at the luxury life, how Napoleon is leading, forgetting the status of all the animals. He doesn't care about the animals. They are working really hard and putting their lot of effort in order to build the windmill, and at the same time they are working so hard in the farm in order to build a beautiful farm, and eats from a special Crown Derby in a dinner service. Look at that. Look at the luxurious attitude of Napoleon. The gun is now fired on his birthday as well as the other two anniversaries every year. Look at that. Earlier they made a beautiful decision. See, as the sign of, as the token of winning the Battle of Cowshed, they are about to fire a gun only in the anniversary. Now on his birthdays, the gun is firing, and all the anniversaries, the gun is firing. Now the rules have been changed. The commandments have been changed, and the leadership has been changed, and ultimately animal farm has no base. The pigs make up titles for him, like father of all animals. Look at that. The pigs, they are the only blind followers of Napoleon, and finally they made him like the father of all animals, terror of mankind. Look at that. Napoleon took lot of titles like father of all animals, terror of mankind, and protector of the sheepfold. These are all the important themes have been noticed. There have been some questions on the themes of this particular chapter, chapter 8. Now we will have a look at a brief analysis of this particular chapter and how this chapter replicates the other scenarios which are there in Russia. The killings are getting too much, and the murders are happening. The killings are happening every now and then in animal farm. It has proven in two different circumstances, and some animals are getting concerned that there are blatant violations of the provisions of the sixth commandment, which says that no animal shall kill any other animal. There is no provision of this particular commandment. Now Napoleon changes the law to read that no animal shall kill any other animal without cause. See, if at all animal dies in the animal farm, he will change that concept into the cause. With these changes, Napoleon receives the license to kill animals easily. The changes being made to the law are indications that Napoleon is determined and very despotic, determined, and the kind of dictatorship which is there in his appearance, to use force or violence to push his agenda. As the reconstruction of the windmill resumes, starvation sets in as the animals lack food to eat. We have discussed these things pretty clearly. Wheeler is, at the other hand, to provide figures ostensibly to justify that the fact that Napoleon has done much as the leader of the farm to boost food production. Napoleon is the kind of a leader who has supported a lot in order to produce lot of foods rather than the earlier times. Wheeler says that there is sufficient food in the country, and that they would have sooner had fewer figures and more food. Squealer says that the animals have their grumbling stomachs to blame, since according to them there is a sufficient food for all animals. He simply propagates like that. Having seized total control of the farm, Napoleon starts becoming a paranoid egomaniac, the kind of a despotic ruler. Napoleon has changed his character drastically. Firstly, he never appears in public, and when it happens, his arrival is heralded by a black cockerel. He took the support of dogs as well as black cockerel whenever he appears in public. Additionally, Napoleon has changed rooms and now sleeps in a very comfortable and separate rooms, and he does not share with the other pigs. He wanted to be isolated for every now and then. He does not want to appear in public. He decided to appear in public every once
in a once in every 2 weeks. Besides, on his birthdays, Napoleon orders a gun to be fired, and that he must be referred as protector of the shield fold. We have seen when the construction of the mill is complete, Napoleon names it as the Napoleon Mill. Look at that. Look at the treacherous nature and very despotic nature and dictatorship. Whatever he says, that will become true. He acts like this, and he finally renames the windmill as the Napoleon Mill. Who does not give any contribution to build that windmill then? See, Napoleon then orders to have all the animals to walk past him as he sleeps on the pile of money after he has sold the timber. But that Napoleon then orders all the animals to walk past him as he sleeps on the pile of money. See, he is simply sleeping on the pile of money which he got from the kind of a fake money he received from Frederick. He was sleeping on it on the timber. In spite of the boasting and feeling of self-importance, the other animals still find it fit to worship Napoleon. See, the innocent animals, blind followers of Napoleon's rule, they still believe that something is going to be turned up in the leadership of Napoleon. In conclusion, we will see rapid developing corruption and degradation of animals during the idealistic revolution. Look at that. Every now and then the entire animal form is corrupted within the hands of Napoleon and Squealer, and they are the ones who made all the animals to work very hard, whereas they are not getting proper food. All animals are running out of food. They are not making a proper preparation in order to receive the winter. Then the windmill project was failed. They again started to reconstruct the windmill. That was also happened, and that was attacked by Frederick. Again, the animals started to give their pushback towards the human beings. Finally, they managed to take away the human beings from the animal farm. See, the abuse of the power is always there, and the part of the pigs have become violent and pervasive. See, the pigs are supposed to be uncontrollable animals now. They are the ones who are making laws, rules, changing commandments, and making all the animals to follow them. They are the ones who are violent. They are the ones who are pervasive, not supposed to follow anybody's word. They are the ones who are supposed to be a complete dictators in the entire animal farm. There is a question of equality and inequality that beautifully comes at the end of this chapter. Again, that remains the concept of inequality, which is always there among all the animals in the presence of Napoleon as well as the Squealer and some other pigs. They are the blind followers, obviously, with their violent technique as well as pervasive manner. So with this, I conclude this session. Thank you very much. Happy reading. Stay safe.